Hello, I am Pierluigi Zinzani. I'm professor of hematology in the Institute of Hematology of the University of Bologna in Italy. Today we'll present an update concerning the current treatment landscape concerning PI3K inhibitor monotherapy. As you know, right now there are four current PI3K inhibitors with an official indication: idelalisib, duvelisib, copanlisib, and umbralisib. Concerning idelalisib, there is an official indication by FDA for relapsed follicular lymphoma patients who have received at least two prior systemic treatment. And also, at the same time, there is an indication also from the European drug agency called EMA with the same indication. Concerning duvelisib, there is an official indication by FDA in a relapsed refractory follicular lymphoma, also in this case, after at least two prior systemic treatments. The same indication is also in Europe, according to EMA. About the third PI3K inhibitor, copanlisib, there is an official indication by FDA for relapsed follicular lymphoma who have received at least two prior systemic therapies. And finally, there is umbralisib that obtained recently an FDA indication in the treatment of relapsed refractory follicular lymphoma who have received at least three prior lines of systemic treatment. And also, there is another official indication by FDA for relapsed refractory marginal zone lymphoma who have received at least one prior anti-CD20 based regimen. Concerning the registration study for all of these four PI3K inhibitors, I will start with idelalisib. The DATRA trial was involved in this study. It's a phase two single arm study. All these patients were rituximab plus alkylating agent refractory indolent non-Hodgkin lymphoma, because the trial included not only follicular lymphoma, but also marginal zone lymphoma, Waldenström disease, and also some patients with small lymphocytic lymphoma. Globally, there were, in the whole study population, 125 patients included. The dose and schedule of IDELA was 150 milligrams twice daily until the progression or was stopped for an acceptable toxicity or death. The primary endpoint of the study was overall response rate. In terms of, you can see here the waterfall plot, very impressive, and there are different columns according to the different histology, follicular lymphoma, small lymphocytic lymphoma, marginal zone lymphoma, and also Waldenström disease. For all study populations, the overall response rate was 57%, and the CR rate was 6%. In terms of progression-free survival, for all study population, the median progression for survival was 11 months. According to the toxicity, so in terms of grade 3 and more toxicity, diarrhea was observed in 13% of the patient, pneumonia in 7% of the patient, and transaminitis, grade 3 and 4, in at least roughly 10-12% of the patients. And about diarrhea incidence, there are a bimodal appearance of gastrointestinal side effects, in particular, as I said, diarrhea or colitis. Early diarrhea, usually self-limited, responds very well to antidiarrheal agents. And at the same time, there is the late diarrhea and colitis, in this case, that occur randomly and can be unresponsive to therapy in the majority of the patients. The second PI3K inhibitor, duvelisib, the registration study was the DINO, also in this study was involved, was also in this case a phase two single arm study, including several indolent non-Hodgkin lymphoma, such as follicular lymphoma, small lymphocytic lymphoma, and marginal zone lymphoma. All these patients were double refractory, I mean refractory to rituximab, and refractory to a chemotherapy regimen or radioimmunotherapy. We included globally 129 patients, And you used the classical schedule for duvelisib according to the phase one study, 25 milligrams twice daily until the progression. And also in this case, the primary endpoint was overall response rate. And in fact, you can see here the data in terms of clinical response for follicular lymphoma, the overall response rate according to the center review was 42%. The CR rate was 1%. The data were quite similar also for the investigator assessment. For marginal zone lymphoma, 18 patients, the overall response rate was 39% and the CR rate was 5%. Concerning the waterfall plot, this case is quite similar to the IDELA data. In terms of toxicity, in the Dynamo study, diarrhea grade 3 and 4 was observed in roughly 15% of the patients and colitis in more than 5% of the patients. The third one, copanlisib, CONUS 1, was the registration study. Also, in this case, I was involved in the trial, including some patients. Is a phase two study, open label, single arm phase two study, including also in this case follicular lymphoma, marginal zone lymphoma, small lymphocytic lymphoma, and also some patients with Waldenström disease. This patient were relapsed refractory indolent B cell lymphoma with failure of two or major to two prior line of treatment. We included 142 patients in this phase two study, and we use the conventional dose of copanlisib according to the phase one study, I mean 60 milligrams intravenous. This is the only PI3K inhibitor with intravenous administration because, as you know, as I said before, in the other three PI3K inhibitors, IDELA, duvelisib, and also umbralisib, there is an oral administration. The schedule is day 1, 8, 15 of a 28-day schedule. And treatment until there is an end of treatment related to the disease progression or unacceptable toxicity. Again, also in this case, the primary endpoint is the overall response rate. This is the waterfall plot according to the different histology. And in particular, you can see here that for all patients, including the study, the overall response rate was close to 61%. The CR rate was close to 17%, in particular for follicular lymphoma, the overall response rate was close to 59%, and the CR rate was 20%. You can see here the median progression free survival was more than 1 year, 12.5 months, and the median overall survival was close to 43 months. In terms of toxicity, diarrhea grade 3 or 4 was less than 9%. Colitis, grade 3 and 4, was only one patient in grade 1 or 2. We observed also hyperglycemia, grade 3 and 4, in at least 40% of the patient, and hypertension, grade 3 and 4, in close to 24% of the patient. The last PI3K inhibitor is umbralisib, the data from the Unity NHL trial, was involved in the trial, also we published the data recently. Phase 2B single arm open label multi-cohort analysis. We included relapse refractory indolent non-Hodgkin lymphoma, in particular marginal zone lymphoma, who received at least one prior line of therapy, including CD20 directed regimen, and also follicular lymphoma or small lymphocytic lymphoma, who received at least two prior line of systemic therapy, including anti-CD20 monoclonal antibody and also anti-dating agent. Globally, we included 208 patients. The dose was a classical dose according to the phase one study. We used umbralisib or oral administration, 800 milligrams once daily until the progression or unacceptable toxicity. Again, the primary endpoint was the overall response rate. You can see here the overall response rate for all the study population, I mean 142 patients, was 47%. And in particular for follicular lymphoma, the overall response rate was 45%, and the CR rate was 5%. And the contrary for marginal zone lymphoma, 69 patients, the overall response rate was close to 50%, and the CR rate was roughly 16%. You can see here the waterfall plot concerning all the study population, different color in the column according to the different histology. In terms of median duration of response was not reached, the same for progression free survival. In terms of median duration response was 11.1 months, and for the follicular lymphoma, in the progression free survival, the follicular lymphoma, the median was close to 11 months. This is very interesting, that data, in particular in terms of median duration response. And concerning toxicity, diarrhea was observed grade 3 and 4 in 10% of the patient, colitis in only one patient, I mean less than 1%. So, and finally, which PI3K inhibitors to use? This is the issue. What to consider for this kind of therapeutic decision among the four PI3K inhibitors with an official indication right now? Drug administration. If you remember, three of them as an oral administration. There is another one with a intravenous administration. Adverse event associated with PI3K inhibitor. You have to evaluate very well, patient by patient, the situation, and comparing it with the safety profile, specific safety profile of each of these PI3K inhibitors. And finally, you have, at the end of the day, you have to choose the drug, the best suits your patients. Thank you very much for your attention.